Welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how constraint layout works using the UI design builder, which is provided by Android Studio. So I have Android Studio 3 with me, and I have created a sample Android project. As you can see on the screen, you have a main activity, which is the launcher activity, and there's a layout called activity main_main.xml layout file, which is associated with that main activity. So let's see how that activity looks like. So if you double click on the activity main.xml, you can see that this particular screen comes up. There are two components to the screen. So one is the design tab, which you can see on the screen, where you have a bunch of elements that we will cover in some time. And then you have our traditional text view, where you can see the XML corresponding to your layout. And also, you can notice that this is a constraint layout, unlike a relative layout that you might have used before. So let's head back to the design screen and let's go through some of the components here. So on the left hand side, you can see that there are a bunch of UI elements, there are a bunch of categories and then UI elements corresponding to that. So for example, in common category, you have a button, you have a text view, which you can drag and drop onto the screens that you see on the right hand side. Now on the right hand side, you see two types of screen. So the first one on the top is called design screen, where you get to see how your activity actually looks like in the actual app. And then at the bottom, you have a blueprint screen where you can actually drag and drop the buttons and you can see how constraints are defined, what are the margins and stuff like that. And you can actually toggle the visibility of the design activity and the blueprint activity using this dropdown. So when you click on this, you can see that currently it is selected design plus blueprint, but you can choose to have just design or just blueprint. So let's quickly see how we can drag drop and how we can use constraint layout to design our activities. So let me maximize this window so that it looks a little bit better. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to drag a button on the screen, and it's not really at the center, but I just wanted to show you something. So let's keep it at that place. You can see it is somewhere between the screens, not exactly in the center. So let's customize its properties. So on the right hand side, you can see all the properties associated with this button. So first of all, you have ID. Let's go ahead and call it my button. And we'll come to what this is in a moment, because I want to show you something else before we go to that. So layout width, layout height, let's keep it as wrap content. And for text, what we'll do is we'll make it my, or we'll just call it click me. And you can see that it has changed to click me on the designer screen as well as blueprint screen. But note, this is not really a good way to define strings. You should ideally define string resource in string.xml under the resource values folder and then provide a reference to it here. Actually, let me go ahead and show you how to do this for this particular case, and then you should do it for all other scenarios. So let me just copy this, go to project, go to resources, values, and then strings.xml, and let's just define another string with name button underscore label, and let's call it click me. So let's go back to our activity layout, and now in the text, you can click on the right hand side, the three dots that you see, and you can select the string resource that you have defined and select OK. And if you maximize this, you can see that click me is still here. So click me is right there. So let's go ahead and add some code to it to show some toast. So let's head back to our main activity. What we'll do here is we'll get a reference to this button. We'll call it my button is equal to find view by ID r.id dot my button, and we'll add a on click listener to it, new on click listener, and inside this we'll just simply show a toast saying that the button was clicked. So we'll say toast dot make toast. We'll just pass the reference to this activity. We'll say min activity dot this, then the text. We'll just say button was clicked, and then you need time, which is nothing but toast dot, let's say, long, and then finally we'll say show. Again, just a reminder, never use hard-coded text. The ideal way to do it, this would be get resource dot get string r dot string dot button label. So you should ideally define a resource with a unique label in the string resource and then reference it using this. But for this demo, I'm just going to hard code things so as to make this tutorial faster. So once you do that, I think you should be good. So just click on the green arrow so that you know, app gets deployed onto your emulator or the device that you are using, and you should be able to see how it looks like. So this may take some time, so let's wait for a moment. Alright, so the app is now installed on your app and it has opened successfully. But it's interesting to note that the Click Me has been fitted in the top left of the screen, whereas it should have been somewhere in the center of the screen as we had dragged the button to. So to understand why this happened, let's move on to activityMain.xml again. But before we do that, let's quickly check that our toast message works. So let's click on Click Me button, and you can see that the toast is shown, which is button was clicked. So let's go back to activityMain.xml now. Let me quickly maximize it. And now if you go to the text, you can see that it has generated certain attributes for this button, which is absolute X, absolute Y, and which is kind of in DP. But it is very important to know that this values are only used to render the button inside print screen and the design screen. It is not actually used to render the position of the UI element. To do so, you need to define constraints, which we will see in a moment how to do that. So to do that, click on the button. And some time back, I had told you we'll see how the constraints work. So the plus things that you see on the top right hand side, those are nothing but constraints. So to add constraints, you can either use this four buttons or four dots, or you can use this four dot. So I'm going to show you using this dots. So click on it and you can basically drag it and reposition it to the sides of the screens. Now what I have done is I have mentioned that the button is equal distance from top of the screen, bottom of the screen, left of the screen, right of the screen. And you can see that getting reflected here as well. You can see that the distance from each of the side is 8. You can go ahead and make this 16 or maybe a little bit more. And you can see how the button shifts to the right. So we want the button to be in center, so let's keep it at 8 for now. So before we deploy this, let's quickly go to text and see. And you can see that the margin end, left, right, start, top, all are 8 dp. And that is how the button is situated on the screen now. So let's save this and run the app again. And let's see what happens this time. Alright, so the app is installed now, and as expected, you can see that the Click Me button is on the center of the screen. And now if you click on it, you can see obviously our toast is shown. But it was important to understand that you have to manually define constraints of your UI elements. Now the constraints could be relative to another UI element that you have on the screen, or it could be relative to the screens that are on the left, right, top, and bottom. Right, so let me click on the button again, and you can see that the constraints are shown on the screen on the top right hand side. If you want to remove a constraint, you can simply click on this particular button, which is X, and you can see that the constraint is gone. To add it back, you can again click on the plus, and you can see that the constraint is back on. Now you can see it says 455, which is why it has kind of shrunk to the bottom. Let's make it 8 again so that it is in the center again. And now it is again equidistant from all the sides of the screen. And if you want to remove all the constraints, you can go ahead and select this. You can hover over this and you can see it says clear all constraint. Now if you click on it, it will remove all the constraint for this particular button. So let's quickly add it back again from this particular UI this time, and you can see kind of all the lengths are different. So let's go ahead and make it 8 so that it is equidistant from all the edges again. So that's pretty much it. In the next video we'll see to make a little more complicated UI based on constraint layout. But if you have any questions on this, feel free to ask. Thank you.